Yo, what's up, everybody out there? This is Loz Taylor from While She Sleeps, and you're listening to Total Rock.
Total Rock, and I'm very excited. I'm reunited with Loz of While She Sleeps, and I think he has something very exciting to share with us. They got a brand new album coming out March 29th. It's called Self Hell, and this is their sixth album. So I had to say that. I'm sorry. Started with a dead pun. How are you doing, Loz? Thank you very much for joining me.
No problem, buddy. Yeah, I'm doing good today. How are you?
I'm very good. You have some great
Good.
stuff coming up ahead. The album is coming out technically tomorrow, Friday, March 29th. You're
Yeah.
heading to Europe for a few shows and then some in-stores shows around the UK on launch week. North
Yeah.
America in May, Rockin' Park, Rock'em Ring, Download Fest. That's going to be very sweaty. Grass Pop, tons of rock, Year on Air, more Europe. What's the
That's
most
it, bro.
exciting thing up ahead? What are you waiting for?
We've been sat on the record for a little while now, so we're very, very excited to get the record out there for our fans to hear what we've been working on. Absolutely love festival season. There's nothing better than playing shows and hanging out, watching other bands as well. I think that's one of my favorite perks of being in a band myself is the opportunity to be able to watch so many other bands as well, free of charge. It's a very, very lucky to be in that position. So festival season's amazing, and we got a bit of nice weather today. That's why I choose to do the interviews outside. But on the whole, the weather can be pretty dull in the UK. So when we can get out there to Europe and play in the sunshine and meet people and meet our fan base and, like I say, watch other artists, that's always it's always a nice thing to do. So stoked for that. And yeah, stoked for the album to be released.
Yeah, looking forward to both. I actually had to listen to the album and some very
Okay.
interesting stuff. We already enjoyed the Tell track and To the Flowers and also Down. So we got a mixture of emotional and angry and loud and sweet. Can we
Yeah,
talk a
yeah.
little bit about the message behind the album? Is there some sort of a story that we need to pay attention to?
There's a couple little things with it, really. I feel like Self Hell as a record, in terms of what the lyrical content is, and from song to song, I think it's very representative of how life can be. One minute everything's going really great, and the next minute, you might be shrouded in negativity. But yeah, I think it's representative of that balance and both sides of the coin there. I think what's really nice about the title is that, more and more these days, people are focusing on themselves, the self-love. And I think that the way that the title came about was through having discussions about people being more aware of self-help and the fact that you have to start with you if you want to see positive change. When you write down self-help, you get to self-hell first before you put the P on the end of the word. And there was something really nicely poetic in that. I think you have to naturally you have to go through things in life that are uncomfortable in order to find out how to get to the self-help. So I feel like you have to go through self-hell before you get to self-help. And that for me is very representative of the ups and downs and the balance of positive and negative, and taking from these experiences and trying to prevail in a positive way from life lessons. So there's lots in there, really, but yeah, poetically for me, being able to write down self-help and get into self-hell first is just there's something quite beautiful in that for me.
So it's all personal because sometimes I kind of get in my own head and then I imagine things that the author never intended. But I felt like I saw some political messages, something a bit more global. Is it something that I saw or something that we can see as well?
Yeah, I think so. The way that I like to write lyrics is that it can be open to interpretation from the listener. I like things to be a little bit more open-ended than finite. And that for me enables a fan that's listening to the record to be able to take their own meaning behind words. That's something that I've always enjoyed with writing, and when what something might mean to us as a band or myself might be completely different for a listener, but I think that's kind of like a really beautiful thing about lyric writing, and hopefully it's relatable but still open enough for you to make your own interpretation. I wouldn't say that every single thing in the record is exactly what we've been through or what we're feeling. But yeah, I think the best place to write from is personal experience. You know, it's like, what else do you really have to write from unless you're writing like fiction in a fictional sense? So yeah, we try and write from personal experience, but leaving lyrics open-ended enough for our listeners to take away from it something for themselves.
And one of my favorite tracks on the album is actually the final track, Radical Hate, Hatred, Radical Love. And I want to connect it to what you just said about that process of self-help to self-help. Are those two extremes the only options? Radical love, is it a good thing? I kind of feel like I heard that before in some sort of like couples therapy. So is that something that we should aspire to, radical love?
Depends how tense of a lover you are, I guess. I think that the idea of that is again both sides of the coin. I think that what we need to, in a way, balance a radical hatred is to find some sort of love that redirects our thinking process. And that also, like you mentioned, it does stem from a bit of a political vibe. You know, there's a lot of propaganda out there that speaks on radical love. At times, there's parts of religion that speak about radical love and how to balance that. I think all the way through from hatred to love, well, you know, take out the radical, you know, for a moment. Again, it's about that, the other side of the coin. You know, you might be having the best day ever. You might be in the best relationship. You don't know what's around the corner. And I think with While She Sleeps, the message is always to try and prevail in a positive way. Even though, if you know, self-help on the surface might feel quite negative, but our message throughout all of our records is trying to be like, nobody's on their own in these feelings. There's millions of people out there that feel very similar and go through similar things day to day. You're not alone in that. The world and life can be a bit shit sometimes, but it's how you prevail, it's how you move forward, and how you take life lessons from being comfortable in the uncomfortable, I guess, knowing that things can change quickly, and sometimes for positive, sometimes for negative, but trying to learn from that and take it more in your stride, I guess.
Well, I like that. You've already added so many layers that I'm going to go back to the album and try and see if I can find them there, whether it's personal or in between people or actually something a bit more global. So I love that. And I cannot wait for everyone to
Great
enjoy
stuff,
that
man.
and add more of their interpretations to our discussion. I want to
Sick.
confront you with something that I feel like I found because Self Hell is the first album that While She Sleeps released after Corona. And I feel like a lot of it, especially when we know that Self Hell is about kind of the struggles within ourselves, so it comes from the darkness of Corona, the uncertainty of what's coming up next. I know that during Corona, a lot of us went back to watch Netflix. I know that a lot of us love Friends. So I want to talk about that moment that you decided to ditch the Rachel Green haircut and come up new on the other side. How is that that moment for you and the band?
What, me cutting my
Yeah, because we all know that you
hair?
represented Rachel Green going back to the 90s, and then you came out the new Prince Laws.
I think that over the years we found ourselves, you know, in the metalcore genre. When the band first got together, we were all sort of had a mutual love for early 2000s metalcore bands like Killswitch and Unearth, All That Remains, Still Remains, As I Lay Dying, you know, Darkest Hour, so many good bands. And I think we, like, whether it was a confidence thing or whether it was just be like trying to keep things a bit safe, I think that I just fell into the trap of, you know, cut off t-shirts, tight, you know, black jeans and long hair. And I think for a while, you know, I'm not the most confident person all the time. So I think that, like, a lot of that was a bit of a safety thing. And I think over the years we are representing ourselves in a way that's more like who we actually are, you know, having more fun with things, being more confident day to day and from record to record. And I was sick of like feeling like the Undertaker on stage, you know, just like looking gross, being really tired, crawling around. And, you know, that was a part of my life that was really cool. But I've always been into like style and fashion, that side of things. And I think that it just felt like time to start expressing myself. And I think that what people are going to find with Self Help as a record is that it's more representative of the fun we are now having in a live sense. We're not like, I think we used to be a bit more serious, and there were a lot of internal things that we sort of suppressed. And I think now that we're moving forward as a group of people, as the Sleeps family, if you like, and I think that we're all feeling more and more comfortable, more open to expressing ourselves in the way that we want to, and giving less of a fuck about what people think, you know. That's where we're at, and we're having fun with that, and yeah, I hope that people can feel that energy, and I hope they take away from Self Hell as a record what, you know, where we're at as a band, and what we're trying to express.
Well, I love that. Thank you very much for your honesty. And I love how it sounds. I love how it looks. I saw you guys over the summer. I love how you add everything from kind of comical to philosophical to intense to fun. So I love that.
Yeah, bro.
Let's talk about the future. We said that the album is coming out March 29th. Loads
Yeah.
of festival shows, launch week around the UK. Can we talk about bigger shows around the UK? Blink once for yes, twice for definitely yes.
You know, I think, you know, I think when you're in a band, you're kind of in the bubble of people feeding you information, and you catch wind of things maybe happening, and you want to forge a plan for the future. At the moment, we're enjoying, you know, where we're at. We want to see how the record goes down. Like you said, like we're moving into a sort of space where we're playing the biggest shows we've ever played, kind of like moving towards being an arena band. And that's really, really exciting. If you'd have told me that when I was a kid, I'd have probably passed out and had a nosebleed, you know? So just trying to be in the moment and be grateful for what we have. Like you mentioned earlier, coming out of a pandemic, you know, it kind of gave a lot of artists time to reflect about what if that, you know, what if touring didn't come back? And I spent half of my life, like over half of my life on the road being, you know, completely out of it and hungover and partying too much. So I think that now it's about being grateful for the opportunities to see parts of the world that, you know, we might have taken for granted at times. And yeah, just being grateful for where we're at as a band. So definitely talks and big plans for the future. But, you know, let's see how this record goes down, and keep your eyes and ears peeled for an announcement on a tour.
Well, I love that. I love that. I keep on looking and clearing my schedule so we can meet up by an arena very, very soon. Laws of Why She Sleeps, Self Hell is out March 29th. I've already had a listen and I love it. They're around the world for the next couple of weeks. So sync up your calendars. It's been a pleasure talking to you, Laws. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you for your time, bro. Have a great day.